Twitchelpuss. Daddy's gold tooth gleamed each time he taunted, "Hey, Twitchelpuss," pointing to his son's erupting facial tic as the child withered with embarrassment. What was his twitch if not an SOS, a neural switch flipped on by the roller coaster chaos in his house that could have, should have been his home? God knows how he remained sane, suffering his parents' angst by day and a terrifying visitor each night, her coal black cape flapping as she flew through the window pane. She'd keep her evil vigil at the foot of his bed as he tried to stay awake, to hold a fetal pose of knees to nose, and never let his legs stretch out lest she'd grab him by the toes. If she did, she'd drag him from under his covers and out the window to an even darker place. There was no one to save him, as Mommy's brooding moods descended easily and often to a lashing fury fueled by her pain-filled fate. She wailed, "Damn you, God, for saddling me with a gallivanting husband, and far worse, for ripping my firstborn from me. For God's sake, he was only 8. And then after countless cups of the fruitless bitter tea I gulped and gagged on, you delivered me this squalling, stubborn child, such a lousy swap for my gifted boy. But now, I swear to you, and the devil too, even if I have to pry open his clenched teeth and jam his goddamn meals down his throat, I'll keep this one alive." She did. And he is.